Since 2001, the Philippine-American Medical Mission of Mercy has helped more than 25,000 people, many for whom even the most basic necessities such as health care are beyond reach. Families for whom comfort and hope are dreams they can't afford. When we first met baby John John, his mother worried her son would never walk. Born with severe deformities to his hands and feet, his future prospects seemed dim. His mother prayed every day for a miracle, a prayer that was finally answered in February 2007.
Yeah, some antibiotics.
Led by orthopedic surgeon Tony Aram, mission volunteers work side by side inside a cramped and woefully equipped operating room, delicately separating skin and bone to give a little boy a fighting chance. Thanks to the medical mission and your donations, John John is able to use his hands. And with his new prosthetic limb, John John's future is a little bit brighter.
After surgery, you just see this transformation. A child becomes more active. He just parades around and says, "Hey, I'm normal. Hey, look at me, I'm normal."
Sadly, mission volunteer Kathy Arzadon says there are many more who desperately need your help. The government simply doesn't have the resources to help everyone, and because of the high cost, most will never seek treatment. And yet, for some, even a little can do so much.
Just getting a bottle of vitamins, how big of a difference that makes to a baby, really, because they can't afford it.
But making a difference in people's lives requires more than just donations and vitamins. It also requires an organized and dedicated team of volunteers, something Henry Balagtas, one of the mission's co-founders, is proud of.
Our group is the biggest group in the Washington area, perhaps in the whole United States, because we have a lot of volunteers of varied specialties, doctors from, volunteers from like Bulgaria, Indonesia, from Australia, Canada.
It's the United Nations.
So it's like United Nations, and then we have multicultural volunteers.
But running the annual mission requires vision and hard work. Since its inception in 2001, founding president Joseph Arzadon has put heart and soul towards making every mission a success.
You do it because it's something that you know is right. You do it because you know you have the ability to do it. I do it also because it makes me feel good.
It's a sentiment echoed by many of the mission's volunteers.
God has been pretty good to me, and I feel I need to give back a little bit. And really, these people give me back more than anything I can give to them.
You think you've made a difference this year, Len?
I think I've made more of a difference in my life, which I think hopefully in the future is going to make a bigger difference.
More than 100 volunteers assisted in last year's mission to Pampanga and Romblon, bringing their skills, their dedication, and more than 75 boxes of medical supplies, helping to change lives, one patient at a time. But good intentions are never enough, especially when the needs are so great. In spite of the country's abundant natural resources, more than 25 million people in the Philippines, nearly one-third of the country's population, live in abject poverty. For some who are new to the mission, the first visit can be overwhelming.
When we finally drove up to this clinic and I just saw the people wrapped around, I sunk because I thought, I can't possibly see all these people. It was huge. Afterwards, it felt great.
It can also be a profoundly humbling experience.
When I look at these pictures, I see my kids. And for a parent to allow that, to allow me to do surgery on their precious child, it's a privilege that is beyond explanation.
Joe Arzadon's philosophy is that by helping others, we also help ourselves. And despite the difficult economic times we live in, making a difference doesn't have to be expensive.
Yes, a friend of mine just called me. He said, I can only give you $20. I said, great, you just helped a child for one surgery. Thank you.
Because the mission is driven entirely by volunteers, 100% of your charitable donations go towards the cost of medicine, supplies, eyeglasses, and preventative education. The volunteers provide the rest.
Our volunteers pay for their own transportation, and the local government, they sponsor our food because that takes a big chunk out of a budget.
The need is there because the money that we have is just enough to do it for one mission every year. And sometimes it's not even enough, where Dr. Joe and I will pitch in to be able to buy some more medicines.
One of the mission's long-term goals is to establish clinics and medical facilities that can provide continuing and long-term care for people who have no one else to turn to. Because whether we choose to become active volunteers or help in other ways, mission veteran Paul Harris says all of us can play a part in making someone's life a little better.
But we need the support, we need the money, we need the supplies, and that's the way they can help out and really feel that they're doing a service to humanity.
In the global village we live in, what happens to the least of us impacts all of us. It reminds us that we are all the same, that the human family isn't just yours and mine. It's ours.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I see those kids as my kids, you know. If my kids were in the same position, I pray to God that someone's helping them too.
This year's goal is to raise $50,000 for the 2009 mission, a mission that will take us to the poorest communities in Batangas in the province of Luzon, and to Ojong and Romblon in the Visayan Islands. Please help us make a difference. Together, we can make the world a better place.